Hello students, how are you all? Welcome to new session. In the last session we have started best city of amines. Aryl amines are more basic than ammonia, reasons given. And in gas phase, tertiary greater than, secondary greater than, primary greater than ammonia given. In aqueous phase, secondary amines are always more basic than other amines. So we have completed. Now in this session I am going to discuss basicity of aromatic amines versus ammonia. Aromatic amines are least basic than ammonia because the reason is, here I am writing, aromatic amines are less basic than ammonia. Less basic than ammonia. Because the reason is, aromatic means there is aromatic ring which is directly attached to the nitrogen. Right students? This carbon atom is sp2 carbon atom, more electronegative. More electronegative means the electrons attracted towards itself because electronegative. These electrons are involved in conjugation like this. These electrons are involved in conjugation with the benzene ring. Obviously, on the nitrogen atom, electron density decreases because those electrons involved in conjugation. So, decreases electron density on nitrogen. Electrons less, then less donation to others by nitrogen. So, less donation. Electron donor is a base. If more donated, then strong base. Less donated, weak base. Getting all of you? Yes. sp2 carbon atom, more electronegative. The lone pair of electrons on nitrogen atom involved in conjugation with benzene ring. Hence, electron density on nitrogen decreases. So, basicity of aromatic amines less than that of ammonia. This is the reason. Aromatic amines are less basic than which one, that is ammonia. Very, very important. Now, come to this one. Reasons point of view. When aniline accept one proton, this is proton from acid like HCl, H2SO4. Then this H+ attack it to the nitrogen, then it becomes NH3+. By accepting proton, proton acceptor is a base. Right, then this like this aniline acting as a base, but resonating structures of aniline we will observe. So these lone pair shifted here and this will be shifted to ortho position. It gets negative charge, finally para, finally ortho, finally totally 5 resonating structures are there. Getting? By aniline means it is before acceptance of a proton. This is anilinium ion, nothing but cation. It is after acceptance of a proton. Now, resonating structures of anilinium cation, this one, this is only two possible because cation has no lone pair on nitrogen atom. No lone pair means no conjugation with benzene ring. The only pi bonds involved in conjugation here, these only involved delocalization. One, two structures possible. If more the number of resonating structures, more is the stability of the cation. So now, stability of cation increases, basicity also increases. Students, aniline has 5 resonating structures, but the cation has only 2 resonating structures. So resonating structures of cation, 2 only, low number, that's why stability of cation low and basicity also low. Right? Now, aniline has five resonating structures, anilinium cation has only two resonating structures. Hence, anilinium cation is less stable than aniline. Anilinium cation less stable. Cation less stable means, hence, aniline is less basic. If the cation formed by aniline is less stable, then aniline is less basic. Stability of cation decreases, basicity also decreases. Hence, aniline or aromatic amines are less basic than which one? Ammonia. Very, very important. Now, after this, if we compare electron withdrawing groups and donating groups, then in such cases, this is aniline with electron donating group. It is only aniline. Aniline with electron withdrawing group. I am taking electron withdrawing group. Okay. Electron donating group is there. It gives electrons to the which one? That is nitrogen. Electron density on nitrogen atom will be increases, more electrons. Easy to donate electrons. Electron donor is a base. More donation, stronger base. Right. Electron donating groups increases. Electrons donation to nitrogen atom will be increases. Electron density on nitrogen atom in aniline will be increases. Then electron donation to others will be increases. More electron donation, stronger base. Hence, basicity increases. And withdrawing group is there. Withdrawing means all the electrons on nitrogen atom will be taken by the withdrawing group. Electron density on nitrogen atom decreases. No electron to donate to others by nitrogen. That's why less electron density on nitrogen, less donation, less is the basicity. Now, electron withdrawing group increases. Electron density on nitrogen atom decreases. Electron donation becomes decreases. Donation to others will be decreases. Now, hence, basicity decreases. Getting? Electron donating groups examples are, methyl group, ethyl group, propyl group, etc., whatever the group that is, okay? Otherwise, OCH3 also you can take. And next, electron donating groups examples, students. Those are COOH, SO3H, NO2, etc. These are examples. If these groups are there, basicity decreases. If these are there, basicity increases. Right? This is. Finally, aliphatic amines more basic than ammonia than aromatic amines. In aliphatic amines, it is electron donating group. Electron density on nitrogen atom increases, more electron donation, more basicity. In aromatic amines, benzene ring is electron withdrawing group because of sp2 carbon atom, electron withdrawing. Obviously, these electrons are involved in conjugation. So, less electron density on nitrogen atom, less donation, less basic. intermediate one is ammonia. Put a box for the students. Very, very important. Now few examples are very, very important. Examples. Those are, first of all, secondary ethyl amide, C2H5, NH-C2H5. Tertiary, C2H5N, C2H5, C2H5, tertiary. C2H5, NH2, primary it is. Next, benzyl amine it is, CH2, NH2 it is, benzyl amine. Next, NH3. Next, so this is NCH3, CH3. Next, benzene ring, NH-CH3. Next, benzene ring, NH2 it is. Students, these are all under aromatic amines. Yes. And these are all under aliphatic amines. Getting, students? And this is ammonia. Okay. The order will be greater than order. Basicity order will be greater than, students. Basicity order. Order of basicity it is. Order of basicity. Right? I gave you yesterday, secondary is always more basic than others in aqueous medium. That's why secondary. Secondary amine. Tertiary in ethyl amines. If you take methyls, primary you'll get. It is primary. Next, benzyl amine. N added to the carbon atom, which undergoes sp3 hybridization. N is not attached to the benzene ring. That's why it is aliphatic only, but not aromatic. In the first video we have discussed. N added to benzene ring here. That's why aromatic amines. Aromatic amines are least basic. And two alkyl groups are there, donating groups. That's why more electron donation to the nitrogen. Electron density and nitrogen more. Obviously, nitrogen can donate electrons to others more. More is the basicity. One methyl group, but here only aniline, least basic. Getting? If you know the order of this, then you can answer for all the textual questions. Solve textual questions also. Next, students. After this, this is the basicity of amines, students. Now, the second property of amines is, that is, the first property of amine is basicity of amines. The second property of amine is alkylation. This second property of amine is alkylation. We have studied alkylation in the preparation of amines, that is called ammonolysis. We read already. So RNH2 reacts with alkyl halide. H and X removed as HX, then RNH, R will be substituted. Again react with alkyl halide. This H and X removed as HX, RNRR. It means you'll get primary amine to secondary amine, tertiary amine. Again RX, then RNRR, one more R, plus it is X will be minus. It is quaternary ammonium salt. Given clearly, students, I think you have written. So on alkylation, by primary amine, secondary, tertiary and quaternary amines will be formed. We read as it is when you follow ammonolysis reaction. Next, students. Acylation. Another one is, third one is acylation. Acylation means acyl group, CH3CO group will be substituted in the place of hydrogen in amine group, that is NH2 group, right? It means acyl group, it is CH3CO group, will be substituted in place of hydrogens in amine group, hydrogen in amine group, it is amine group, right students? It is nucleophilic, nucleophilic substitution reaction. It means CH3CO minus will be substituted in place of hydrogen. Then nucleophilic substitution reaction. So if you take primary amine, 2 hydrogen, secondary amine, 1 hydrogen, tertiary amine, no hydrogen. It means CH3CO group is substituted by hydrogen only. If no hydrogen, no substitution of CH3CO group. That's why primary and secondary amines having hydrogens, those only involved in acylation reactions. Yes. Aliphatic or aromatic, aromatic primary and secondary amines reacts with esters, otherwise acid halides, otherwise anhydrides, anhydrides gives amides on acylation. Getting students? So equation C2H5NH2 I'm taking. So for example, like this I'm taking HNH2. This is treated with CH3COCl. Acid halide it is, which contains CH3CO group. Then so here which is added, so this will be minus, it will be plus. So here lone pair will be attracted here students. Then we will get C2H5NH, H losing electrons, correct, plus it is C connected, O becomes O minus, to this already CH3 is there and already Cl is there. Getting all of you? These two will be shifted here, N becomes neutral, and these two electrons shifted between carbon and oxygen. So chlorine is removed as a Cl minus, H is removed as a H plus. So then forms C2H5NH it is only. So single bond, C double bond O, CH3 left, plus HCl is removed. H and Cl is removed. Students, then it is amide, CONH group, 1, 2, ethyl group is a N-ethyl, it is N-ethyl, 2 carbons are there, eth, en, amide, N-ethyl, ethanamide will be formed. Getting? Here a base is required to neutralize HCl formed in the above reaction. Then only we will get N-ethyl ethanamide. Simple. This hydrogen is replaced by COCH3 group, and this hydrogen and Cl is removed as HCl. Right students? You can take acid halide. It is acid halide, acyl halide, nothing but. It is ethanamine, ethaneamine, ethanamine it is. Getting? Acid halides and ethanamine. Next, after this, one more. Secondary amine, it is a primary amine students. C2H5N and this is HC2H5, secondary amine. Treated with, this time I would like to treat with CH3COCl. CH3COCl it is, right? Then the same thing students, this H and Cl is removed as HCl directly, then forms C2H5NC2H5CO is attached and CH3 it is. 1, 2 carbons in the longest parent chain, these two will be substituents. So substituents will be nth position, N comma N. 2 ethyls are there, sorry, methyls are, ethyls are there, correct? Diethyl, eth, en, amide, ethanamide, because two carbons are there, ethanamide, right, with SL halide. Otherwise, another one also you can take, benzene also you can take here. Benzene means this is like this, benzene NH2 treated with ester CH3 C double bond O, O C double bond O CH3. COO group is there, I think it is anhydride. Okay, then hydrogen, and this group is eliminated as a CH3COOH, then the formed compound is CH3COOH, a benzene ring with NHCOCH3. It is nth position is a phenyl group, N phenyl, it is 1-2 carbons are there, ethanamide, it is ethanamide, N phenyl ethanamide will be formed. You can take other compound also, not only this, you can take ester also and anhydride also, whatever it is. So here primary, secondary I used. Here it is primary amine, it is secondary amine, getting, it is secondary amine. With tertiary amines, no reaction students, no reaction. With tertiary amines, no reaction, because no hydrogen. Even benzoylation also takes place, it is acylation. Benzoylation means here benzoyl chloride will be taken. Benzoylation also possible. Yes. Amines on benzoylation. Benzoylation. Benzoylation means, yes, it is O. Benzoylation. CH3 NH2. Benzene COCl, benzoyl chloride it is, right? Hydrogen and Cl is removed as HCl students, then we will get CO NH CH3 it is, right? N phenyl, sorry, it is N, no, it is N will be added. CH3, actually it is CH3 NH CO benzene ring, correct it is, right? This will be formed N methyl benzamide, which is added benzoyl group. Benzene with CO group is called benzoyl group, will be substituted in place of hydrogen of amine group, getting? Yes. Now students, CH3 NH2 with CH3COOH, then what is the product? It is also having CH3CO group, acyl group, chance to undergo acylation, but this is base, because amines are bases, CH3COOH acid then forms salt but not amides. Getting students? Salt formation is possible instead of amide formation, very very important. Even though acids having acyl group, they will not involved in acylation with amines, because salt formation will be possible, right? Next, carbyl amine reaction, fourth property is carbyl amine reaction. Property number 4 is carbyl amine reaction, also called isocyanide test. It is a test only for primary amines but not for secondary and tertiary amines. Aliphatic or aromatic amines, especially primary amines, reacts with chloroform in presence of potassium hydroxide, then forms isocyanide. That's why it is called isocyanide test. A very, very important, students, it is for 2 marks question. Very, very important. Yes. Aromatic or aliphatic primary amines, a very, very important word is primary amines, react with chloroform in presence of ethanolic KOH, then forms carbylamine or isocyanide. Carbylamine or isocyanide. RnH2 plus CHCl3, 3 moles of KOH, it is alcoholic. Then RnC plus 3KCl plus 3H2O, it is isocyanide. Right, students? It is a foul smell compound. Foul smell means a bad smell compound. Right? It is a primary amine, not a secondary amine. Example for this reaction is CH3NH2, remaining as it is, students, 3KOH, then CH3NC it is, plus 3KCl and 3H2. Methyl isocyanide will be formed. You can take, it is aliphatic primary amine. You can take aromatic primary amine also. Same thing, aromatic isocyanates will be formed. If you take aromatic primary amines, you will get a benzene ring, it is with NH2. It is aromatic amine, primary amine, that too a primary amine. Aromatic primary amine. Getting? Treated with chloroform in presence of 3 moles of KOH, then give the rest to phenyl isocyanide it is. Right, students? This is formed along with the byproducts KCl and H2O. Why only primary amines involved but not secondary and tertiary? If you take secondary, 2 alkyl groups are there already. NC it is, RnC, students. N valency is already satisfied, 1 plus 3, there are 4 bonds already satisfied. If I took a secondary amine, there are 2 alkyl groups, one more alkyl group must be on nitrogen atom. Difficult to arrange on nitrogen atom because already valence of nitrogen atom satisfied with 1 alkyl group and 1 carbon atom by 3 bonds. If I take secondary and tertiary amines, it's very difficult to arrange 2 or 3 alkyl groups on nitrogen atom. Only 1 alkyl group is possible to accommodate on nitrogen atom in this structure. That's why only 1 alkyl group amines are primary amines, those only involved in which one? Carbyl amine reaction or isocyanide test. Very, very important in your objective exams or PUC exams also. Primary amines. This test is not given by secondary and tertiary amines. Secondary and tertiary amines. Only primary amines. Right? Next. After that, reaction with nitrous acid. Fifth reaction is reaction with nitrous acid. The formula of nitrous acid is HNO2, that is. Next one is reaction with nitrous acid. Formula of nitrous acid is HNO. Reaction with, it is I think fifth one, nitrous acid, HNO2. Nitrous acid, okay, HNO2. So primary, secondary, tertiary amines, maybe aliphatic or aromatic, can react with nitrous acid in a different way. In your textbook, they gave only primary amines react with which one? Nitrous acid. Primary, secondary, tertiary, aliphatic or aromatic amines can react with HNO2 in different manner. Right, students? Now, aliphatic primary amines first react with HNO2, what will be happen? Aliphatic primary amines react with HNO2 gives diazonium salt. Unstable diazonium salt which gives nitrogen gas on reaction with water. Right, students? Yes. RNH2, it is aliphatic primary amine, reacts with HNO2. Actually, HNO2 produced from NaNO2 plus HCl. HNO2, NaCl is eliminated. Then RN2 plus Cl minus, it is called diazonium salt. Di means 2, azo means N group, Cl minus it is. This is treated with water, then gives rise to alcohol plus nitrogen gas plus HCl will be removed, right? This is, you can keep here CH3NH2, methyl amine, HNO2, as it is, CH3N2 plus Cl minus, then water, CH3OH, N2 plus HCl, it is methyl alcohol. Getting, students? Yes. This is a diazonium reaction, otherwise diazotization. If I took aromatic primary amines as it is, aromatic primary amines on reaction with nitrous acid gives benzene diazonium chloride, gives benzene diazonium chloride, one of the important class of organic compounds, that is benzene diazonium chloride, at low temperature, that is aromatic one is benzene ring with NH2. Aniline it is, aromatic primary amine, treated with NaNO2 plus HCl, then it becomes HNO2 at 0 degree Celsius to 5 degree Celsius, 273 to 278 Kelvins, then gives rise to N2 plus Cl minus. Getting? It is a benzene ring, students. Benzene, 2 means di, azo, N group, onium means plus sign, it is chloride. Positive sign indicates sodium, hence it is called benzene diazonium chloride will be formed, a special class of compounds. Even secondary tertiary amines can also react with nitrous acid in a different way. That's not given in your PUC syllabus, right students? So with this we have completed the next property, that is the fifth property, reaction with nitrous acid. This reaction is called diazotization. Temperature is 273 Kelvin to the 5 degrees means 278 Kelvins. You can take degree Celsius or anyone, right? So these are the properties of which one? Amines. So totally 5 properties I have completed. I hope you understood. In our next class we'll continue this next property, that is electrophilic substitution reaction.